Hello everyone, welcome to the second part of maths chapter triangles, or you can say congruency of triangles. So in the first part we studied about applying SAS test, side angle side test. Today we are going to learn about ASA test. So two triangles are said to be congruent if two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding two angles and the included side of the other triangle. Two angles and included side of one triangle are equal to corresponding two angles and included side of other triangle. Okay, now let's take an example over here very quickly. We have two triangles ABC and PQR. Now these two triangles can be congruent by ASA congruence criteria only if the two angles of the first triangle, let's say these two angles, are equal to two corresponding angles of the other triangle, okay, and the included side means if we are talking about angle A and angle B, the included side would be AB. If we are talking about angle P and angle Q, the included side would be PQ. So two angles AP and BQ, A angle A and angle P, angle B and angle Q are equal to each other, and the included side, right, AB and PQ, they are equal to each other. If this is the case, then the two triangles are congruent by ASA congruence criteria. Okay, so we can say that here triangle ABC is congruent to, you remember correspondence, right, is congruent to triangle PQR by ASA test. ASA means angle side angle. Okay, so that's the second test after SAS. Let's go ahead. Okay, there is one more corollary with ASA, that is AAS, angle side, angle side congruence criteria. If any two angles and a non-included side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding angles and side of another triangle, then the two triangles are said to be congruent by AAS test. Let's draw the figure. Let me replicate this. Okay, so these two triangles I'm taking X, Y, Z and J, K, L. Okay, so in these two triangles, two angles, let me take one angle, maybe this one, and one angle over here, the other angle over here, and here. Okay, so Y is equal to K, angle Y is equal to angle K, and angle Z is equal to angle L. Okay, so that's the case, and so two angles are equal, and we have to take a non-included side. So the side should not be between these two angles, it can be any third side. Okay, let me take this side. This side is equal to the corresponding side of other triangle. Here the only difference is we have two angles, we have a side, but the side is not between two angles like the previous one. In this one, the side was between two angles. That's why this criteria was known as ASA congruence criteria. But here, the side is not included between two angles, and that's why this criteria is known as AAS congruence criteria. AAS congruence criteria. Please remember that very well. Okay, so when to apply AAS and when to apply ASA is very, very crucial. Now, remember one thing, that you can also make a mistake. So the mistake you can make is confuse yourself between ASA and AAS. Always look at the location of the side, whether it is included between two angles or it is like this, it is not included. One more thing where you can pay some extra attention is, always remember that the angles and the side must be corresponding. Okay, only then the two triangles are said to be congruent. Okay, so suppose in this case, if I say that XZ is not equal to JL, but XZ is equal to JK, will these two triangles still be congruent? Will they be still congruent by AAS congruence criteria? Please answer yourself. Will they be still congruent? Absolutely not. Why? Because in congruence, only equality does not matter. Not only equality. What matters is correspondence. So the location of the sides which are equal to one another in both the triangles must be corresponding to each other. Only then the two given triangles are said to be congruent. Okay. So that's one of the very important thing. Try to understand that. Okay, so here we know that these two triangles are congruent by AAS and these two triangles are congruent by ASA. So out of the five tests of congruency, we have studied about SAS, ASA, AAS, and after that we are going to study the next thing which we are going to study is SSS. But before we study SSS, there is one small theorem which we need to prove. Two angles, if two angles of a triangle are equal, then the sides opposite to them are also equal. So in this triangle ABC, angle C and angle B are equal. Can you see angle B and angle C? They are equal. We have to prove that AB is equal to AC. This is what we have to prove. This is what is given. So here we have to draw one construction, like earlier when we proved this isosceles triangle property in the last video, we drew one angle bisector. In this figure also we are going to draw one angle bisector of angle A. So the angle bisector of angle A meets the side opposite side BC at D. So angle BAD, this part, and angle CAD, they are equal to each other. Okay, let's start. So how we will prove this? Proof. So in triangle ABD and triangle ACD. So what is the first thing which I did? The first thing is I considered the two triangles ABD and ACD. Why did I consider these two triangles? Because just look at what do I have to prove. I have to prove okay, so we have to consider these two triangles because the sides which we have to prove equal, AB and AC, are the part of these two triangles. ABD has AB and ACD has AC. If we prove these two triangles congruent by any criteria which we have learned so far, And if we can apply CPCTC, that is corresponding parts of congruent triangles, then we can get some parts to be equal to each other, right? The desired parts which are asked to be proved. So let's write how to prove. So again, revisiting our concept of congruency, what is the first thing we need to do to prove two triangles congruent? We need to list the parts which are equal to each other. So the first thing is angle ABD is equal to angle ACD. Angle ABD is equal to angle ACD. Why is it so? It's given. What else is equal? Angle BAD. Angle BAD is equal to angle CAD. So the first thing is angle ABD is equal to angle ACD, given. Then angle BAD is equal to angle CAD by construction. Why by construction? Because we have constructed one angle bisector AD which divides angle A into equal parts. What is the next part which is equal? AD is equal to AD. Why? Because it is common. AD is equal to AD. Why? Because it is common. AD is in both the triangles, so it's common. So we have got two angles and one non-included side. Is AD included between these two angles? No. So it is a non-included side. But is it corresponding? Yes, it is corresponding. Are the angles corresponding? Absolutely they are. As we can see in both the triangles, the position of angle side all are corresponding. And therefore, we can say that triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD by AAS test. By AAS test. So these two triangles are now congruent. So we can say that therefore AB is equal to AC by CPCTC. AB is equal to AC by CPCTC. Okay, so we have proved that these two triangles are congruent and the sides opposite to equal angles are equal. Opposite to angle B, which side is there? AC. And opposite to angle C, which side is there? AB. So AB and AC are equal to each other. That's what we have proved. Okay, so that was one theorem which is very important. You can say converse of isosceles triangle property also to this theorem. Okay, next is SSS congruence criteria. I just told you that we have studied SAS, ASA and AAS till now. Now the fourth one which we are going to study is SSS. Now from the name of this congruence criteria, you can figure out that this congruence criteria relates with side, side, side. If three sides of one triangle are equal to three corresponding sides of other triangle, then the two triangles are said to be congruent. There are no angles in this, only sides, corresponding sides. Okay, sabse easy hai isko apply karna, to visualize also it's very easy. Okay, so for this proof, SSS congruence criteria, we are not going to look at how to prove two triangles congruent by SSS criteria, but we are just going to focus on what is SSS congruence. So suppose that we have two triangles which are exactly equal to each other, equal in all respect. Let me show you in a fresh figure. So one triangle is PQR and the other triangle And the other triangle is D E F. If we have two triangles PQR and DEF, in which PQ is equal to DE, PR is equal to DF, and QR is equal to EF, then the two triangles are said to be congruent by SSS criteria. So triangle P, triangle PQR is congruent to triangle DEF. Okay. Please take care of correspondence while proving any congruency. Okay. By SSS test. So that's the simplest test. No need to do its proof. Proof of congruency. Proof of proving two triangles congruent by SSS test. Let's directly go with the examples. First question. Prove that perpendicular drawn from the vertices of equal angles of an isosceles triangle to the opposite sides are equal. So this triangle ABC, which you see here, is an isosceles triangle. And in this isosceles triangle, we know that the base angles are equal. And from those base angles, two perpendiculars are drawn to the opposite sides. We have to prove that the lengths of these two perpendiculars are equal. Now, as you can see in the figure, I'm going to try to draw both the triangles separately and show you. One triangle is BLC, which we must consider, and the other triangle is BMC. Okay, why do we have to consider these two triangles? Because we have to prove that the perpendicular drawn from B and C to AC and AB respectively are equal in length. So CM and BL are the perpendiculars drawn from C and B are equal in length. Okay. If CM and BL are equal in length, we have to prove that, then we must consider the triangles which have BL and CM inside them. That is triangle CMB and triangle BLC, the red triangle and the green triangle. Now, again, I'm going to draw these two triangles separately, so that you know that which triangle I'm talking about. Okay, so let me draw the first triangle. Now this triangle which I'm talking about here is, this is M, this is B, and this is C. And another triangle is BLC, BMC, BLC. See, we know one thing, that BL is perpendicular to LC or AC, and CM is perpendicular to BM or AB. One more thing which we know is angle ABC, or angle MBC as you can tell, is equal to angle LCB or ACB, this angle. Correct? So we have this much of information. What we have to prove, again, BL is equal to CM. Okay, so given is written here, in triangle ABC, angle BCA is equal to angle CBA. BL is perpendicular to AC or CA, and CM is perpendicular to AB. And we have to prove that BL is equal to CM. So, ye do triangle humne bana liye. Now, proof. in triangle CMB and triangle BLC. CMB and BLC, if you can see these two triangles, what is equal in these two triangles? Angle CMB is equal to angle BLC. Angle CMB is equal to angle BLC, both 90 degree, both 90 degree, right? Why they are both 90 degree? Because CM and BL are perpendiculars, we know, na? They are perpendiculars drawn from the vertices B and C respectively to the opposite side. What other things are equal? Angle MBC is equal to angle LCB given. Now you will ask, where is it given? This one, angle BCA is equal to angle CBA. BCA is this angle, CBA is this angle. CBA or CBM or MBC is part of the green triangle, as you can see here. BCA or BCL or LCB is the part of the red triangle, as you see here. Okay, so we have two angles which are equal, corresponding angles. What else is equal? BC is equal to BC. Why? Common. Therefore, triangle CMB, CMB is congruent to triangle. Before writing congruency, we must figure out the correspondence. We must find out the correspondence. So what is corresponding with C? If you say with C, C is corresponding, no. With C, B is corresponding. These two are corresponding parts. With M, L is corresponding. And with B, C is corresponding. So triangle BLC. Triangle CMB is congruent to triangle BLC by. Okay, now we have two angles and one side which is not included. This side which is equal to this side, not included side. So by AAS test. Okay, and therefore we can say that CM is equal to BL CP CTC. Proved. Only this much. Understood? Very easy. So I want you to note it down. Now that I have solved it for you, you know the method. I want you to note it down. In fact, I want you to solve it while watching the video. So what you do is you pause the video now. Don't look at the answer. Don't look at the solution. Look at the question. Write the question. Don't write the question. Write the given to prove. Draw the diagram and write the proof yourself. And then compare your proof with the proof which I have written. Is our method same? Are we writing with the same method, same technique? Right? If you do that, what happens is the homework which you gave me, some students, you know, they did not follow my instructions. I've already talked about it. So this will not happen in the second part now. I want you to improve. Don't repeat the same mistakes, or this time I'm not going to accept your homework if you are not following my instructions while doing homework. Correct? Let's go ahead. Okay, next. If altitudes from two vertices of a triangle to the opposite sides are equal, prove that the triangle is isosceles. Now, this is exactly opposite to what we just proved. Here, they have given that altitudes from two opposite vertices. So, in this triangle, can you tell me, can you find the altitudes from two opposite vertices? See, one altitude is drawn from B, on AC, which is BL. This is one altitude. And the other altitude is drawn from C onto AB, which is CM. BL and CM. These are two altitudes from two vertices of a triangle on the opposite sides. And these altitudes are equal. That means BL is equal to CM. That is given to you. See, BL is perpendicular to AC, CM is perpendicular to AB, and BL is equal to CM, which is given to you. What you have to prove that this triangle is isosceles. That means AB is equal to AC, or angle ABC is equal to angle ACB. If you prove that also is okay. So you have the figure with you. Now again, because it is similar question which we have done in the previous part, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this figure and copy it over here. Let's see what works out from this figure. Okay. Okay. So here we don't have one thing. Let's remove that part. Okay, so let's remove this part of angle B and angle C. We don't have this. We have to prove that actually they have not given to us. BC is equal to BC. Yeah, that could be common, but still let me remove it for making it more clearer. Okay, BL is equal to CM is given to us. BL is equal to CM. Okay, what else is there? The altitudes from two vertices of a triangle to the opposite sides are equal. Prove that the triangle is isosceles. Okay, I think it could be proved, but not with the help of the test which we have done, or I can't think of okay, maybe not these two triangles then. Okay, I made a mistake, slight mistake in choosing the triangles. I blindly chosen the triangles which could not help me. Okay, now I'm going to show you one more triangle which I can see. Can you see this triangle? ABL. Can you see ABL? And can you see ACM? ABL and ACM. Can you see these two triangles? Great. Okay, so let's draw them separately so that we understand there is no overlapping. Let me just remove everything from here. Okay, so the first triangle which I'm going to consider to prove that AB is equal to AC, or angle ABC is equal to angle ACB. Actually, if you have to prove this part, angle ABC and ACB to be equal, you have to take the triangles which I took earlier. But with those triangles, we cannot apply AAS test, right? The test which we are talking about right now. That's why we will not prove angle ABC is equal to angle ACB, but we'll prove AB is equal to AC. We are going to prove this, and I'll show you how. So the first triangle which I'm talking about is triangle A, B, L, where BL is perpendicular to AL, And the second triangle which I'm talking about is it is A M C, where AM is perpendicular to CM, AM is perpendicular to CM, or CM is perpendicular to AB, you can say AB or AM. Okay, so these are the two triangles which we are considering, which we have to prove congruent. Anything else you see congruent in these two triangles? Now, if you see the overlapping triangles in this original figure, they are over here. One is here, okay, and the other one is over here. What is common between them? Forget about what is equal. What is common between them? The one thing which I can see common in both the triangles is this angle. So that is angle A, which is there in both the triangles. Acha, angle ALB and angle AMC both are 90 degree. What else is equal in both the triangles? If you are thinking that BL is equal to CM, you are absolutely correct. BL is equal to CM because it is given to us. So we already have found the triangles which we have to prove congruent, which will give us AB is equal to AC. And we have also found the parts which are already equal, three parts, which are minimum three parts are required to prove any two triangles congruent. We have already found it. So what is the proof? See, to draw this separate figures is not mandatory, but if you draw it, it helps you a lot. By now you should know that, you know, your visualization is aided by this separating the, you know, overlapping figures. Okay, so what is the proof? Let's consider the triangles first. So in triangle ABL and triangle ACM, what is equal? Angle BAL is equal to angle CAM, right? Both are common. We are talking about angle A, okay? Both triangles have angle A as common. What other parts are equal? Angle ALB is equal to angle AMC. ALB is equal to AMC, both 90 degree. Both 90 degree. As you can see, both triangles have 90 degree angles. Okay, what else is equal? BL is equal to CM. Why? Because it is given. And therefore, you can say triangle ABL is congruent to triangle. Okay, correspondence. Always write correspondence in rough, okay? Not in fair. If you write in fair, it's not a problem. But always write it somewhere, so that you know that what is the exact correspondence with which I have to write my name. Angle A is corresponding with angle A, B, part B is corresponding with part C, and L is corresponding with M. Triangle ABL is congruent to triangle ACM by AAS, angle side test. And therefore, we can say that AB is equal to AC, C, P, C, T, C. And therefore, triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Okay, triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Now, you need to pause the video and you need to write the whole solution yourself. It's very important. And compare your solution, your method of writing with mine. Done? Let's go ahead. Okay. AB is a line segment. AX and BY are two equal line segments drawn on opposite side of line AB. So AX and BY are two equal line segments. Okay. AX is equal to BY are two equal line segments drawn on the opposite side of AB. Okay. One is above AB and one is below AB. AX and BY. Okay. Such that AX is parallel to BY. If AB and XY intersect each other at O, if AB and XY intersect each other at O, prove that triangle AOX is congruent to triangle BOY. Okay. And AB and XY bisect each other. That is okay, great. We can do that. First, let's write given. What will be given in this? AX is equal to BY. Second thing, AX is parallel to BY. One more thing, AB and XY intersect each other at O. Okay, fair enough. This much is given to you to prove. Let's write to prove. Number one, triangle AOX is congruent to triangle BOY. That's number one. Number two, AB and XY bisect each other. AB and XY bisect each other. If AB and XY bisect each other, we can say that AO is equal to OB and XO is equal to OY. XO is equal to OY. AO is equal to OB and XO is equal to OY. Okay, that's what we have to prove. Okay, no constructions. Directly we can write the proof. No need to draw the diagram. Diagram is already given. Nothing else has to be done. Proof. Angle AXO is equal to angle BYO. Alternate interior angles. Now you must be wondering where did this alternate interior angle scene came in from. So angle AXO is this angle. Angle BYO is this angle. Why these two angles are equal? Because AX is parallel to BY. Why? Because it's given. So if the lines are parallel, then the alternate interior angles will be equal. XY will act as a transversal. You know it, right? Alternate interior angles. Great. So angle AXO is equal to angle BYO, alternate interior angles. We have already known that. Acha, one more thing I would like to show you. Angle AOX is equal to angle BOY. Vertically opposite angles. You know vertically opposite angles? These two are vertically opposite angles. Great. So now we can prove these two triangles congruent. Therefore, in triangle AOX and triangle BOY, angle AOX is equal to angle BOY, vertically opposite angles. Angle AXO is equal to angle BYO, alternate interior angles. Okay, and AX is equal to BY. ax is equal to by, we can say that sides. Oh, hey, ax is equal to by is given to you. It's nothing but given. Okay. So therefore, triangle AOX is congruent to triangle BOY by angle side AAS test. Okay. So these two triangles are congruent. What else we have to prove? Okay. So therefore, we can say that AO is equal to OB, CP, CTC, and OX is equal to OY, CP, CTC. So we have proved these two, and therefore we can say that AB and XY bisect each other. AB and XY bisect each other. Clear? So this is how you prove two triangles congruent to each other. And yeah, that's all. Please pause the video, note down the whole solution, not by copying but by solving yourself, and then compare with my solution which is there in front of your screen. Pause the video and do the task, please. Today is going to be a long video. There are total 18 examples. Some of them are easy, some of them are tricky, so we are going to get a lot of time in this video. Done? Let's go ahead. Okay, next one is here. In two right triangles, right triangles means right angle triangles, okay, one side and an acute angle of one triangle are equal to one side and corresponding angle of other triangle. Prove that the two triangles are congruent. Hey, this is very easy. So let's say that angle ABC, triangle ABC and DEF are two right triangles such that BC is equal to EF. Okay, let's show it here. BC is equal to EF, and angle ACB is equal to angle DFE. Angle ACB, which is this angle, is equal to angle DFE, this one. Okay. And of course we know that angle ABC is equal to angle DEF is equal to 90 degree. These two angles are equal to each other. We have to prove that these two triangles are congruent. It is already done. So how are these two triangles congruent? They are congruent by ASA test. Two angles, two corresponding angles of both the triangles and the included side between them are equal to each other. That's why these two triangles are congruent by ASA test. So what I want you to do is pause the video right now and do the whole solution yourself. Write the whole solution yourself. There should not be any issue. Given is given to you. To prove is given to you. Diagram is in front of you. You just have to write proof. You need to consider the triangles first, write the names of triangles, then list the parts which are equal, then prove them congruent, and write the test of congruency which is applicable. That's it, you're done. Take care of correspondence. That's one advice I would give you. Can you please pause the video and do it? Great. Okay, so I hope that you have done this. Now let's check the solution. Right? This is it. They are congruent by ASA test. Okay. This is the solution. Please check your solution with this. Great. Let's go ahead. Okay. In the figure, AB is equal to AC. Okay. So they have given you two figures. In both the figures, we'll consider it and we'll prove congruency according to one of the figures, because it will be applicable to both the figures. So don't worry about it. If you are seeing that in which figure you have to consider all this, it's very easy. I will tell you in both the figures. Okay. So AB is equal to AC. DB is equal to DC. Prove that angle ABD is equal to angle ACD. So here, angle ABD is over here and angle ACD is over here, which you have to prove equal. And in this figure, angle ABD is here and angle ACD is here, the big angle, which you have to prove equal. So whichever we have to prove equal, I'll just erase it from the diagram. Okay. So let's write given. AB is equal to AC, BD is equal to CD. To prove angle ABD is equal to angle ACD. Angle ABD is equal to angle ACD. That's what you need to prove. Okay. Let me first do a construction. Construction, join AD in both the figures. Okay. In both the figures, you have to join AD. So let me do a construction with the help of red ink. So it will be easy for you to see. Okay, red ink construction. Okay, done. We are done with construction. Great. Join AD. It is done in both the figures. Now proof. Now remember what we have to prove. We have to prove angle ABD is equal to angle ACD, and angle ABD and ACD are different in both the figures, but the proof will be same. Amazingly. Okay. You don't have to prove two times for both the figures. Just one proof and it is enough. Okay. To prove angle ABD and angle ACD equal, I will consider triangle ABD and triangle ACD in both the figures. Okay. So in triangle ABD and triangle ACD, in triangle ABD and triangle ACD, what is equal? AB is equal to AC. Why? Given. Okay. What else is equal? BD is equal to CD. BD is equal to CD. Why? Given. See, AB is equal to AC, BD is equal to CD. AB is equal to AC, BD is equal to CD, right? What else is equal? AD is equal to AD. The red line which we have constructed, it is equal in both the triangles. Why? Because it is common, right? So in both the triangles, we have listed the equal parts, and surprisingly, it comes out to be all the three sides. And therefore, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD by SSS test. By SSS test. Okay. So we have proved that these two triangles are congruent. Now, therefore, angle ABD is equal to angle ACD CPCTC proved. In this triangle, ABD is over here, ACD is here. In this triangle, ABD is over here, ACD is here. But the proof, the steps, they do not vary. They are the same for both the triangles. Proof, the steps of the proof, the method is absolutely same. Only the figures are different. So that's also possible, right? Easy? Very easy. Please pause the video, draw the diagram properly, write given to proof construction, and write the proof yourself and compare your proof with my proof. You can take help of the diagram, but not of the proof. Okay? Proof you have to write yourself and compare it with my proof, which I have written in front of you. Okay, please pause the video and solve it. Done? Let's go ahead. So I have used SSS test and I have done a construction. But if you see, they have not done any construction. They have not done any construction and their proof is a little complicated. So I will suggest that you use my method because it is more easy, it is more simple. With one simple construction, you can prove these two triangles congruent very easily, and you can prove whatever you want to prove with this easy method, right? So my method I consider to be easier, and I advise all of you to follow this method. Okay, next question. In figure, L is parallel to M. Okay, L and M, we can see two lines are parallel. O is the midpoint of line segment A, AB. So AO and OB are equal. Prove that O is also the midpoint of any line segment CD having its end point on L and M respectively. So we have to prove that O is midpoint of CD. Now in here, I'm going to help you with given. What is given? Given is L is parallel to M. What else is given? AO is equal to BO. What else is given? O is midpoint of line segment AB. Okay, nothing else is given. So what is to be proved? To prove O is the midpoint of CD, OC is equal to OD. O is the midpoint of CD, OC is equal to OD. Mm-hmm. Okay. So given to prove any construction, not required. Okay, proof. Which two triangles will consider for proving OC is equal to OB? We'll consider triangle AOC and triangle BOD. Can you see these two triangles? Now, I just want you to focus on the figure and tell yourself, what do you think is equal in these two triangles? First is AO is equal to BO. Why? Because it is given. Next is angle AOC is equal to angle BOD, vertically opposite angles. One more. Samajh mein aaya kuch? Angle CAO is equal to angle DBO, alternate interior angles. Why alternate interior angles? Because line L and M are parallel and AB is a transversal. So alternate interior angles formed between two parallel lines and a transversal are equal. And therefore, triangle AOC is congruent to triangle BOD by which test? By ASA test. Okay, by ASA test, these two triangles are congruent, and therefore we can say that OC is equal to OD. C, P, C, T, C. That's what we had to prove, OC is equal to OD. So we proved these two triangles congruent, and then we proved OC is equal to OD by C, P, C, T, C. Very easy. Very nice. Let's go ahead. Yeah, of course, you need to pause the video and write the whole solution before moving ahead. Always remember, don't just look at the video, because you know I've seen students, you know, they just look at the video just like a any other entertainment video and just do the homework directly. Don't do that. You need to solve the whole question yourself. Done? Let's go ahead. Okay, great. The next question. So you see here a quadrilateral. This is a special kind of quadrilateral. Just by looking at it, you can tell that this is a parallelogram. Okay. But in the question, they have not mentioned anything about the parallelogram. So what they are saying is BL and DM are both perpendicular to the segments AC. Okay, let's write given BL is perpendicular to AC, DM is perpendicular to AC. And BL is equal to DM. Both these perpendiculars are equal in length. BL is equal to DM. So this is what is given. You have to prove that AC bisects BD. AC bisects BD. Okay. So to prove AC bisects BD, that means AC divides BD in two equal parts. So AC and BD, they intersect at O. So where will AC bisect BD? At O. That means you have to prove that BO is equal to OD. That is, BO is equal to OD. So this is what you have to prove. Okay, this is not given. Let's remove the signs from here. Okay, BL is equal to DM, that is given to you. Okay, now to prove BO is equal to OD, what do you think, which triangles you must consider? Which triangles you must consider? You must consider triangle BLO and triangle DMO. Triangle BLO and triangle DMO. Okay, so you have to consider these two triangles, which you see in your figure. I'll just remove them, they don't look good. Okay, let's write the proof here. In triangle BLO and triangle DMO, angle BLO is equal to angle DMO, both 90 degree. Angle BOL is equal to angle DOM, vertically opposite angles. If you can see, these two angles are equal to each other and these two angles are 90 degree. And BO is equal to OD. Hey, is it given to you? No, I'm sorry. One more thing. BL is equal to DM. BL is equal to DM. Why? Because it is given. So in these two triangles, we have found three parts which are equal to each other. Therefore, triangle BLO is congruent to triangle DMO by, can you guess which test? We have two angles and one side, AAS test. So if these two triangles are congruent by AAS test, then what? We can say that, therefore, we can say that BO is equal to OD. C, P, S, T, corresponding parts of CP, CTC, I'm sorry, not CP, ST, that is similarity, which you are studying and going to study in class 10th. CP, CTC, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay, BO is equal to OD. So very simple, right? Pause the video and write the proof yourself and then compare it with what I have written. Done, let's move ahead. In figure, ABC is a triangle in which AB is equal to AC. Okay, we can see that AB is equal to AC. BA is produced to D. BA is produced. Produced means extended. Okay. BA is extended up to D such that AB is equal to AD. AB is equal to AD. Okay. So AB is equal to AD and AB is also equal to AC. Prove that angle BCD is 90 degree. Now this is definitely nothing to do with congruency. You have to prove that angle BCD is equal to 90 degree. It's very easy. Just see how we'll do it. In triangle ABC, I'm not writing given, okay? You have to write given in this because it's not of congruency. So I'm not doing everything for you. This is an easy question. Let me solve it for you. In triangle ABC, angle ABC is equal to angle ACB. Angle ABC is equal to angle ACB is equal to X. So these two angles, both the angles we are taking, going to take as X. Let angle ABC is equal to angle ACB is equal to X. In triangle ACD, let angle ACD is equal to angle ADC is equal to Y. So let these two angles be equal to Y. These two angles are equal, right? Why these two angles and these two angles are equal? Angles opposite to equal sides. And here also you'll write angles opposite to equal sides. Now somebody will have this doubt that it's a very valid doubt that if this side AB is equal to AC and you have taken these two angles as X because angles opposite to equal sides are equal, and in this triangle ACD AC is equal to AD, and here you have taken Y, why not X? I will tell you the reason. Suppose we have one triangle like this and one triangle like this. Okay, so this is 3 centimeter, 3 centimeter. Here also it is 3 centimeter, 3 centimeter. But what about the angles over here? Of course, the angles here, the base angles here and here are equal, but they are. So the base angles here, they may be different than these two base angles. So in two isosceles triangle, even if the equal sides are of the same length, but it's not necessary that the base angles of both these isosceles triangles are same, because it all depends on the vertical angle. If the vertical angle is small, then the base angles will be large. If the vertical angle is large, then the base angles will be small. Okay, so that's why I have taken in one triangle base angles as x and in other triangle the base angles as y. Okay, angles opposite to equal sides are equal. That property I have used in both the triangles ABC and ACD. Now, just change your perception to a little bigger picture in this whole thing. Look at triangle, consider triangle DBC. Can you consider triangle DBC? In triangle DBC, angle DBC plus angle BCD plus angle BDC is equal to 180 degree. Why? Angle sum property. Angle sum property. So what is angle DBC? Angle DBC is X. What is angle BCD? Angle BCD is X plus Y. Right? Angle BCD is the whole thing. There is one X and there is one Y. So X plus Y. Plus angle BDC is Y. And this is equal to 180 degree. And therefore, we can say that 2X plus 2Y is equal to 180 degree. And therefore, 2 bracket X plus Y is equal to 180 degree. And X plus Y is equal to 180 divided by 2, that is 90 degree. So X plus Y is 90. And what is X plus Y? X plus Y is this angle, and that is angle BCD, which is 90 degree. Right? So we have proved that angle BCD is equal to 90 degree with this method. This was a very simple, very easy method. Please pause your videos and solve this question for me with proper method, proper steps, statements, reasons. Done. Let's go ahead. In the figure, two sides AB and BC of and the median AD of triangle ABC are equal to the two sides PQ and QR and median PL of triangle PQR respectively. Prove that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Amazing question. Okay, now look here. They have mentioned median. Now I hope you remember what median is. Median is a line joining vertex of a triangle to the midpoint of opposite side. So AD and PL, these are two medians and they are equal in length. These medians are equal in length. Not only the median, AB, the whole side AB is equal to the side PQ, and BC, the whole side BC is equal to the whole side QR. Medians are equal and two sides are equal. Only this much is given. And you have to prove that these two triangles are congruent. The whole triangle ABC and PQR are congruent. How we will do that? Let's write given. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR, median AD is equal to median PL, AB is equal to PQ, and BC is equal to QR. to prove. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Okay, let's start from here. Proof. Now, I want you to consider two triangles first, which are not the original triangles. Okay, with the triangles which I want you to consider for simplicity is one, this triangle, and the second one is over here. Triangle ABD and triangle PQL. These two triangles we will consider first. Okay. I will tell you why. You will understand if you watch this proof carefully, you will understand the whole thing, whole process. In triangle ABD and triangle PQL. In triangle ABD and triangle PQL, AB is equal to PQ. AB and PQ are equal. AD is equal to PL. Now these both things are given to you, right? What next? BD is equal to QL. What is the reason why BD is equal to QL? It is not given. Since BC is equal to QR, which is given, therefore half of BC is equal to half of QR. Half of BC is equal to half of QR. What is half of BC? Half of BC is BD. Why? Because D is midpoint of BC. Why D is midpoint? Because AD is a median that is given to you. And median is a line which joins the vertex to the midpoint of the opposite side. So D is the midpoint. And BD is equal to DC and QL is equal to LR. So BC is equal to QR. So half of BC is half of QR. And BD is equal to QL. Okay. And therefore, we can say that triangle ABD is congruent to triangle PQL by SSS test. And since these two triangles are congruent to each other, we can write one more thing. Angle, look very carefully, this is the trick. Angle ABD is equal to angle PQL. Now, they had not asked me to prove angle ABD and angle PQL equal. They had not asked me to prove these two angles equal. Why am I proving these two angles equal? See, our whole idea is to prove the two triangles congruent, ABC and PQR. But we don't have enough things in these two triangles to prove congruent. That's why I took half of the both the triangles, ABD and PQL, proved them congruents, and then I proved the included angle, that is angle B and angle Q, equal by CPCTC. Okay, so now I can target the triangles which I want to prove congruent. So in triangles ABC and triangle PQR, now I can prove these two triangles because I think I've got everything. AB is equal to PQ. Angle ABC is equal to angle PQR. Okay, so this is given. This is proved. Where is it proved? Where is it proved? It is proved over here. ABD is equal to PQL. ABD and ABC are the same angle. Okay. So there is no issues over there. and BC is equal to QR. BC is equal to QR given. BC is equal to QR given. Correct? Therefore, triangle ABC will be congruent to triangle PQR by which test? By SAS test. SAS, side angle side. Okay, so our target was to prove triangle ABC and PQ are congruent, but we could not do it directly. There was no way we could do it directly. So we proved half the triangle given in the figure first, and then we used CPCT to find the missing part, which was to be proved congruent, which was required to be proved which was required for proving triangle ABC and triangle PQ are congruent. Okay, so this is how you solve this particular question. Very interesting question, very important also. Okay, so see, I have solved 9 questions till now, and there are 18 questions. Okay, so soon I'm going to you know, give you the next video of for finishing this part, but till then, just solve all the examples which are shown by me in this video with this video. So that will be a good practice for you. Also, your concepts will get clearer, and it will be easier for you to, you know, solve the rest of the questions of the particular chapter. Right. So I'll be seeing you in the next video very, very soon. Till then, take care of yourself. Bye bye.